They were pretty weak. Captured more than one dragon. He must have needed them to create this legendary armor.
Interesting thought, lad. And it makes sense. Nearly everything about dragons is useful and contains power. Teeth, scales, even
X-Wing.
Shit.
Dragon shit is powerful?
Aye, lad. Definitely powerful.
That is having fun with you.
Greetings! I just want to make sure you're good and prepared before heading in any further.
There's all manner of nastiness left over from the Mad Dwarf King's foul practices.
What kind of practices?
Oh, various sacrificing, dark enchantments, blood, magic, and so forth. Quite common among the older dwarves, unfortunately. Old habits are hard to break.
Ready and ready.
Oh, that's fine. Always happy just to chat.
Whoa. Look, it's another dragon.
I see it, boy.
Chain. I hope we can find the binding shrines. This place is huge.
Front door. These materials must be pretty special to make a legendary armor.
This legendary armor better be worth the trouble.
But if Brock and Sindri make it together, I'm sure it's worth the effort. Don't you trust them at least?
I trust you, Atreus. I do not trust the legend.
Oh.
To find out, but they're rather messy.
I guess it doesn't matter.
Thank you.
think this dragon would be a bit more supportive, seeing how we're trying to free it.
Freeing them.
Well, yeah. Still seems like the right thing to do.
One vicious son of a bitch.
Boy, over here.
Yes, sir.
Enemies ahead!
number two. This place is even bigger than Vadergard.
Yes. The Dwarf King's reach appears vast.
I wonder what happened to him.
Tis a great mystery, even amongst the sons of Ivaldi. Mozognir's behavior before his disappearance grew increasingly erratic.
Why?
The Dvegrath Eaker, the very armor you find yourself searching for. Though he found two, I'd wager his failure to find the third ingredient drove him to madness.
Yes, sir.
Atreus, to me.
Okay, coming. Still won't open? Looks like we need three.
Yeah.
Dwarfing want this armor so badly. What's so special about it?
There are many legends behind the Dveigrath Ikar. A suspicious amount of legends, which makes confirming anything about this particular armor difficult. But the one constant among them is the ability of the armor to offer ultimate protection. A useful attribute for an unpopular king, you see.
Yet this plagued land is all that remains of him. This is why you do not trust legends, boy.
Well, what can you trust?
Yourself, your eyes, your instincts. Blind trust in a legend is a gamble, and rarely does it pay off.
You say so. Okay. Here we go. Huh. It's kind of run down in here.
What did you expect?
I don't know. Less ruin, I guess? Maybe the throne room's in better shape.
Here, boy. Another one.
Stargather. Wow. That's a lot of arms.
That's fair to say.
Six, seven, 8? Could he shoot 4 bows at once?
More of a swordsman. He did only have the 2 eyes.
Looks like Thor cut him down to size.
It's what he does.
Do you hear that?
No. What do you hear, boy?
Crying. And screams. They're getting louder. They sound almost like... Hellwalkers!
There's a passage behind this throne.
A secret passage?
Well, wouldn't be a proper throne room without a secret passage.
Signir. The things you pulled from him. Those must be the 3 mythical ingredients Brock was talking about.
I can say with utmost certainty that I've never laid eye on a stranger set of objects in my life.
How are Brock and Sindri supposed to build with... whatever they are?
Don't count the dwarves out, lad. They're right pricks, but they're resourceful. They once made an unbreakable chain out of little more than a cat's footstep and bird spit.
That doesn't even make sense.
But that's the legend. If you wanted sense, you shouldn't be talking to a severed head.
place looked like in better times.
Conan'sGard was a beautiful land in its heyday, before the Dwarf King's obsession poisoned his mind.
How could he let that happen?
The Dwarf blindly trusted in the legend and pursued it without thought to the consequences. This is the result.
Trust is a gamble, like you said. And the Dwarf King lost.
You found the legendary materials? Incredible. Oh, this is so exciting. Meet me back at the temple and we'll get started right away.
I didn't think we'd see you out here, since you and Brock got back together. Everything okay?
Oh, better than ever. You know, I really think we've both grown in our years apart.
So how come you're back here?
Just catching some fresh air. Look, I love my brother, but he still smells like a fetid dung pile.
We found the materials. But they're so weird. How do you build a piece of armor out of something so...
Nanya.
Nanya?
Nanya fucking business. Trade secret. We got our ways.
Oh.
Been putzing around Niflheim, have we?
How can you tell?
I'd recognize Evaldi's stench of failure anywhere. Plus, you still got some mist on your shoes.
Something else we can do for you?
Nah, just glad you guys worked it out.
Ah. Well, I could say the same to you.
Ha!
I guess I was getting a bit full of myself.
Told him what he needed to hear, how's it sounds to me.
Just the same. I'm sorry for how I spoke to you, Sindri. You forgive me?
Already have. Like you said, it all worked out. Now, let us get back to work before I get sentimental.
Better not be fighting with your brother again.
Just because he's gotten a little less annoying over the years doesn't mean I ain't got a customer base of my own to keep happy.
Oh yeah? Who's that?
Well, you came back here, didn't you?
Fair point. This is it, right? The Rockstall?
Aye, lad. The Council of Valkyries.
The Valkyries are of Valhalla, are they not?
Glad to see you're paying attention, brother. You are correct. Valhalla, the Great Hall of the Einherjar, is their home within Asgard. But while there, they are subject to the scrutiny of the Allfather himself. And relations between the Valkyries and Odin were tense during my tenure as his advisor.
Why?
Well, that's an even longer story, lad. For now, why don't we look around for some clues? Thinks he can hear you, lad. The Helms must only retain but a small portion of their owner. I'd wait.
Come here. Who is she?
Gunnar, Mistress of War. After any conflict, big or small, she would be first on the scene, sussing out the worthy spirits for a free trip to Valhalla. A gruesome task, but she took great pride in it.
Any conflict? Impossible.
It's true. She had help from her sisters, of course, but Gunnar was always first to arrive. Her judgment of the fallen was unparalleled, and an invaluable resource to Odin. She was one of his favorites. Ah, Gondul. Beautiful Gondul.
And?
Huh?
That's it? Beautiful Gondul? No story or anything?
Sorry, lad. The sight of Gondul always took my breath away. Gondul had a silver tongue, a sharp wit, and struck a finger. You're so stunning it literally drove men insane. Odin forbid her from setting foot in Midgard after a time. As insanity is not a welcome trait in Valhalla. This is none other than Geirdrifol, the master of arms in Valhalla, responsible for arming and training Odin's Einherjar.
His what?
His army, come Ragnarok. The entire reason Valhalla exists, you see. The Einherjar wait in the Great Hall endlessly, feasting, drinking, and fornicating themselves silly. Once Ragnarok begins, Odin calls them into service to fight on his behalf. Geirdrifol had her hands full training that lot. This, my friends, is Kara. Now, Valkyries are volatile by nature, but Kara, the lass is Wild Storm personified.
A Wild Storm?
Aye, calm and collected. Then the air would shift and the fury of her storm would unleash. It was beautiful in a way, assuming you could find proper shelter. Her tears would cleanse the blood-soaked battlefields. This is Rota, a chooser of the slain.
I thought all the Valkyrie did that.
Not exactly, lad. Although that is what they're most famous for, and by far their greatest responsibility. You've seen what happens to the dead without the judgment of the Valkyries.
Hellwalkers.
That's right. Rota, Gunnar, Skuld. Without them to clean up the aftermath of battle, Hell overflows with souls meant for Valhalla. A sorry state of affairs. Rota must be beside herself.
A Valkyrie healer? Strange.
Eir was strange, matter of fact. Very quiet. Very calm. Where her sisters were violent rapids, there was a gentle stream. She healed the wounds of both mortals and gods. And even a certain all-knowing sage who once drank too much and fell off a mountain. Not my proudest moment. Well, well. Hildr, Mistress of Battle. She and Odin got on quite well, actually. Her and the other Valkyries, not so much. She would spend most of her time here in Midgard observing discord between the living, and sewing some up herself from time to time. She lived for conflict. Some say she was conflict personified. I wonder what will become of her now that she's free. Olrun, once the daughter of a powerful chieftain. She fell defending him during a Reaver attack. Olrun was escorted to Valhalla, where she chose to devote her afterlife to the pursuit of knowledge above all else. Quite unusual behaviour amongst the constant drinking and feasting of her fellow Valhallian denizens.
How'd she end up a Valkyrie?
Odin. He saw a kindred spirit in Olrun's single-minded pursuit of knowledge. He appointed her as a Valkyrie's resident historian.
Yeah! Huh!